Now, let us discuss the illumination pattern due to diffraction by a single slit. Here, we already discussed in previous sections that for a single slit, first minima is located at theta is equals to sine inverse of lambda by b. This is the angular width of central maxima. Now, if we discuss various cases of a slit width, like in case 1 we say, if the value of b is very, very greater than lambda, that means the slit width is quite large, then in this situation here you can see theta is sine inverse of lambda by b. If the slit width is large, this will tend to 0. And if a central maxima is of a negligible width, that means a slit patch will be obtained. That means if this is the single slit and the width is large, then on a screen you can simply say a rectangular patch is obtained due to the incident light which is falling from the slit to the screen. So the width of central maxima will be negligible and a patch is obtained which is corresponding to a rectilinear propagation of light. Thus, we have initially discussed that whenever the size of obstacles are large or not of the order of wavelength of light, the prominent diffraction is not seen or it cannot be percepted. Now, if we consider a situation of case 2, where we say if slit width is not very large but it is greater than lambda, this implies the value of theta we are getting is sine inverse of lambda by b, and if b is more than lambda or if it is of the order of lambda, the diffraction pattern will be seen. So in this situation here we can write diffraction pattern is seen, which we have observed as well as analyzed in the previous sections. Now, if we consider a situation of case 3, where the value of b is equals to lambda, and if b is equals to lambda, then in this situation the value of theta we are getting here is sine inverse of 1, that is pi by 2. That means the first minima or the width of central maxima is extended up to infinity. If theta is pi by 2 for the edges of central maxima, then here we can say this implies central maxima will extend up to infinity. That means on the screen there will be a gradient of illumination which is observed if this is the slit, and in front of a slit we can see the intensity will be I naught. And on the two side, the intensity will be decreasing function of theta. This will be decreasing as a function of theta on both the sides. If anywhere we are finding intensity at an angle theta, and at theta is equals to pi by 2, this intensity will drop down to 0 for first minima, upward as well as in downward direction. So there will be a continuous gradient of intensity from center to upward and in downward direction where intensity is decreasing. Now, if we consider a case 4, in which we are given that if b is less compared to lambda or very less compared to lambda, then this implies sine inverse lambda by b will not give any value of theta. That means no minima is obtained. In this situation, we have discussed that minima is obtained at theta equals to pi by 2. This is the position of first minima, whereas in this situation, no minima is there, and if b is very less compared to lambda, we can say almost uniform illumination will be there on a screen, or the gradient will be very less and the intensity will be almost uniform on the screen when we move away from the central maxima. It will be slightly decreasing as the width of central maxima will be excessively increased.